I'll tell you something. A religious singing reminded me of something. Did you see that TV coverage of the Pope when he was lying in state? The last Pope, you know, John Paul.
Yeah.
Lying in state on that on that catafalque.
Yeah.
In those robes.
All right.
Didn't ask him any horn that. Him lying there. He looked so fucking vulnerable, didn't he? I mean, like, I couldn't prevent myself, you know, having a wank immediately because he looked vulnerable. He looked at rest, and somebody had gone to the trouble of plucking all that hair out of his nostrils. I didn't fancy him when he was alive because he had all this fucking hair up his nostrils. But when they'd when the cosmetician had had a go at his body and that,
well, I got a he had a.
I got the fucking horn yeah, just seeing him. Lying well, there.
The makeup was fantastic on that.
Who but done, I imagine...
who done the wardrobe?
What, for the Pope's funeral?
Yeah.
Was it Verity Lambert, was it?
Was it Mr. Fish?
Mr. Fish or...
Yeah, I don't know.
Or could be Mrs. Fish done it, I don't
yeah,
know.
Yeah, I don't know.
She does a lot
it's
of things.
Bloody beautiful. But it's interesting, gave you the horn.
Well, I find I'm, you know, well, I'm attracted by dead popes.
By dead popes, yeah.
And, yeah. You know...
I can understand that. I can understand that. It's enough to give you the horn. Anything gives me the horn, I find. I can look at anything. I look at a picture of a piece of toilet paper. I get the horn.
You get
yeah.
Well,
I get a very hard horn. I get not just the
any
horn.
Any particular? Just Bronco or just Hendrix? What?
Well, no, I don't distinguish. I don't distinguish anything.
Anything gives you the horn.
Anything
it?
Gives me the horn. I'm very lucky that way. Except my wife, Valerie. She doesn't give me the horn at all.
No, she's an ugly
I've
bitch.
I've explained
isn't
she? Her time after time. I said, Val, I said, fuck knows what it is, love, but you do not give me the horn. I said, you fucking don't give me the horn.
I'll tell you what.
But everything else gives me the horn. I went down, I opened a gate, that gave me the horn. I, you know, put my foot on the pavement, that gave me the horn.
Yeah.
You know, everything gives me the horn.
Yeah.
I like that.
Lord Longford gives me the fucking horn.
Oh, yeah.
It's the way he does his hair.
Yeah.
You know, it really gets me going.
Yeah,
I see him wandering about.
Yeah.
He's so fucking fanciful, that Longford.
Fucking hell, mate. I
mean,
tell
I
you,
wish I was in prison for
drives
life.
Me round a bend.
I wish I'd killed a few people. I wish I was in prison.
So
I wish
round.
I was a mass murderer and I was in prison so Lord Longford could come round and give me the horn like he gives other people, you know. Because I only see him in photos and on telly and that.
Yeah.
But in the flesh, I imagine he must be fucking tastic.
You strip me
I mean,
down.
Think of that lucky girl, Mara Hendley,
down to his
sitting there.
Mate.
He's coming round on daily visits to see her.
Mm. I bet he gets. I wonder if he gets the horn.
I'll tell you another thing gives me the horn.
What's that?
The word end.
Oh,
whenever
and.
I see the word end.
You've
in
picked
a, book,
a favourite of mine,
I get so fucking
oh,
horny.
Oh, fucking and, mate. Oh, Jesus. And there's such a lot of it about.
Yeah. This and
fucking
that.
Fucking and
know,
this and that and
this
that.
Gives me the horn, that this gives me the horn.
And that gets. Oh, fucking
if
shit.
If I see a sentence which reads this and that, I'll get such a
oh,
fucking hard on. I don't
and,
know what to fucking
mate.
Do.
I wrote to the editor.
The is another one gives me the horn.
Oh, the. Oh, come.
They keep using
well,
that
you,
one, don't
have you
they?
Been, have you been reading my diary? Have you?
Yeah, I was looking through it, you know.
Oh, fuck
I saw
me.
The
I don't
and,
think that's very nice.
No, it wasn't. What I read was.
You saw my secrets.
Yeah, I saw that
you
one.
You knew
about,
that I liked the and end.
Yeah, I knew that. That's why I mentioned the and well, to see if it'd give you the horn. Of course it has.
Oh, of course it has. Oh,
but you wrote to the... Who did you write to about this?
Well, I sent a round robin.
Yeah, that's no fucking good one. You send a letter.
Well, I sent the letter later.
What, with the robin?
No, I sent robin and then, that you know, it didn't do fuck all, so I sent a letter.
Robin Peter to pay Paul, that is. It's just fucking stupid. Why didn't you write a letter?
I did
write sending some round fucking robin.
I sent Robin round because I thought that would be the way to do it.
What, Robin had the letter?
No, I just sent Robin round.
What good is Robin going round? Where the fuck did Robin go round to?
He didn't go round nowhere. I just sent him round.
Round where?
He came back, he said, where the fuck am I supposed to go? I said, I don't fucking know. I sent you round. Why don't you fucking go round?
Why didn't you send a letter?
Cunt.
What, have you sent a letter?
I did send a letter, yes.
Who to?
I don't know. I don't know. I sent the fucking letter. I wrote the letter and put it in the pillar box. I don't know who I sent it to.
Well, you didn't put a stamp on or address or anything like that.
Fuck that.
Well, why don't you follow what John Cleese says on television?
I do.
He says in order for post to get there, he comes out with all these handy fucking hints. He says put a stamp on a letter and address it. That's what I've been doing since I've seen those ads.
Write the letter and bung it in a fucking post box.
What, with no address?
No address.
Well, did you get a reply?
No. I was fucking furious. I wrote another letter.
What, same method?
Yeah, got no fucking reply again. Cunts. They're all cunts out there.
I wrote to Mrs. Thatcher.
Yeah, well...
I said, dear Mrs. Thatcher, you know, respectful. Mm. Pardon the language, but I've got the fucking horn. And, you know, I thought I'd put it bluntly. Dear Mrs... I didn't call her Maggie. I wasn't familiar. So, dear Mrs. Thatcher,
yeah,
I have got the fucking horn, and I want to know what you, as leader of the Conservative Party, plan to do about it, you know. I was expecting a reasoned reply of some kind.
Yeah.
Well, I get a fucking letter come back saying...
The horn not known at this address?
No.
Oh.
It said, Mrs. Thatcher has read your inquiry with interest, but it will not be part of official Conservative Party policy, though we are sympathetic to your cause. Well, in my view, she hadn't even read the fucking thing.
Right.
I think some fucking secretary looked at it.
Yeah, right.
Wrote to Jim Callan.
Tossed it on one side, if you pardon.
Wrote to Callan.
Expression.
That oily heap of shit. I didn't call him that. You know,
No.
I said, dear sir.
You didn't say dear oily piece of shit, did you?
No.
Oh,
no, because that would offend him. He's teetotal and Welsh. And,
because
no, he's not Welsh, is he? He's just a cunt of some kind. I forget. He comes from somewhere.
Yeah, well, we all do.
All right.
We come from the horn, mate. All of us.
All right, to Jim Callan. I said, dear Mr. Callan, I have got the fucking horn. And I want to know what the fucking hell the fucking Labour Party are going to do about the fucking horn. I got absolutely no fucking reply. He's probably huddling with the TUC.
What's that?
I did a quite good experiment for BBC Two. They're doing a documentary.
Oh, what, on the horn?
Yeah, on the horn. And the documentary people came around, you know, with the cameras. And at first I was a bit self-conscious, you know, like having cameras on, you know, all fucking time.
Yeah, well, fuck
and they
that,
said,
mate.
Lie down on the bed.
Fuck them.
I said, lie down on the bed.
We're
doing this documentary on masturbation, you see.
Yeah, fucking
I said, don't call it masturbation. I said, call it wanking.
Call it the horn.
Call it wanking. Yeah. Call it having the horn and wanking, I said. But they insisted on calling it masturbation, you know, because BBC Two, they have to use long fucking words.
Yeah, fucking cunt.
And I forget who was the producer, Xavier Cugat or something
Radio
like that.
Radio 3, BBC 2.
Yeah, all that stuff.
Fucking...
I said, lie on a bed and masturbate.
Mm.
And I said, well, what is my motivation? And he said, the. And as soon as he said the, I started, you're pumping away, you know.
Yeah,
it all come out, you know, great mass of it. And,
yeah, well, endless gobs.
No, about...
Huge gobs of hot sperm... endlessly into the air, was it?
Quite a lot, and it all landed in me belly button.
And your hair.
And they said, I was just going to get a Kleenex, you know, wipe it out. And they said, no, hold that, that's good. We like that.
Yeah.
We like that. It's very visual,
right,
you see. It said, very visual. They said, could you do that again? Because we've got a hair in the gate. I said, fucking hell, you've got a fucking hair in the gate. You're fucking professionals. They said, it could happen to anyone, you get a hair in the gate.
Yeah.
So I had to do the whole thing again, and he said that again.
Oh, what?
And I waited away for about half an hour, because I only just come. And then they said, I said, is that all right? You know, I came, and they said, no, we can't buy that one. I said, why not? They said, because you fell short of the belly button.
Yeah.
I said, well, fucking hell, what do you expect the second time around?
Should have got me, mate. I can come every 5 minutes.
Well, I sent them round to your place. I told Xavier Cugat, whoever's in charge of the fucking crew, I said, go round to Derek's place. He'll give you a proper wank and hit his marks. I wrote to the fucking BBC after his experience with them, you know, coming in my navel, then falling short, and then them all pissing off. Load of cunts, BBC.
Fuck, what are
they
fucking know about the horn?
They drank all my Guinness.
What does BBC Two know about the fucking horn?
Nothing.
Fuck all.
I said to them, go around to Derek's place, he'll show you.
Show you, mate.
He'll show you. And I wrote a letter to them. I said, dear I wrote to whatever the fucking name is, the head of the fucking BBC.
Dear cunt.
Yeah, that's what I said.
That's it, yeah.
I'll put cunt London on. You know
how to
find
it. Cunt
London.
Cunt London. TV centre.
No, not even TV centre. You don't know how to put TV centre. Cunt London. It reaches the Director General of the BBC. You can be certain of that.
Yeah.
So I said, dear cunt.
Yeah.
Your fucking crew came round my fucking place last night and tried to film me fucking masturbating.
Right.
And I did it perfectly well the first take.
Right.
And they said they got a fucking error in the gate.
Yeah.
And I'm paying 25 quid a fucking year to have a fucking colour licence, and this is the fucking service I get. And I said, if we have any more Joyce Grenfell repeats, I'll come round to the TV centre.
Beat you to death with the fucking horn.
Beat you to death with my horn.
Get my fucking horn out and beat the old fucking TV centre down.
And what reply
I'll fucking raise it.
What reply did I get? Dear sir, we thank you for your inquiry. And we regret to say that we are unable to bring it into BBC Two planning this coming year, but we'll bear it in mind. So I sent round, bear it in mind. Get the sarcasm of that. The subtle sarcasm of it. Bear it in mind.
Bear it up your arse, mate.
Yes, precisely.
Bear your arse.
You know that big nigger who lives down the road?
Oh, him, lovely.
I said to him, I said, Ephraim, strange name, isn't it, for a black?
Yeah.
I said, there's a load of cunts at the BBC and they need sorting out. I said, this should appeal to your fucking primitive urges. I said, you like cannibalism, don't you? You like eating people alive in a frying pan. I said, go round to the BBC with some of your mates dressed up in your loincloths and that and paint yourself up in different colours, you know, whatever you cunts do back in Africa. And so he said, oh, that's nice, that. And he said, what do we do when we arrive? I said, go berserk, tear the fucking place
spunk
down.
Spunk all over the fucking
spunk
centre.
All over the Director General.
Yeah.
And kill everyone in the studios, you know. Yeah. And he was all, you know, he got about 40 of these coons gathered together to rush around to the BBC. And I was, you know, I was really looking forward to it. I was looking forward to tuning in to the news that night and seeing the news on the BBC.
Yeah.
The BBC had been burnt to the fucking ground.
40,000.
I turned on the 9 o'clock news. There was Kenneth Kendall. Calm as a cucumber.
Yeah, wait.
No story about anything fucking burning down. And do you know what the cunt, black nigger puff cunt said when he came back?
No.
He said, oh, I'm sorry. I couldn't find it.
No.
I lost my way, he said. Lost your fucking way, I said. You're more likely wanking down Lambeth. Kenneth Kendall gives me the horn.
Oh, what?
Kenneth Kendall.
Oh, blimey, Kenneth. Well, you know. I wish I didn't get the horn so much, though.
I wish I didn't. Of course,
my knob aches.
One day, you know, when you're very old,
you
won't get the horn anymore. When you don't get the horn, you'll say, I wish I had the horn. That's what you'll say.
Do I have to say to Valerie, I can't do it, I've got a knob ache? And she says, like, fuck you, you cunt. I said, I have, I've got a knob ache.
What does she know about it? She's a woman.
Well,
she got a knob? Oh, she to fucking talk. She got a knob?
Well, she ain't got one of them.
Put that question to her. If Valerie ever says...
Hey,
to
wait
a
minute.
Ever she has.
She has.
Yeah,
she
I remember
fucking
that.
Fucking hell, she has.
It's a huge knob, isn't it?
Yeah. Fucking hell, I forgot. She has a knob. Valerie has a knob.
She had it as long as you've known her, or is it just a sudden thing?
No, come to think of it, which I do, she's had it... She's had it ever since we got married. Oh, I have to go and see Valerie about her cock. Maybe she's got them.
Well, you could probably, on the health these days, you could probably have a knob increased.
I don't want it increased.
You get a supplementary benefit.
No, I don't want it increased. No.
You want it reduced?
No,
well, then you had to fill in a lot of forms to get reduced.
No, I just have to get used to it, really.
But couldn't you get tax relief on an unemployed knob?
Probably.
Well, I should go into this with your accountant down the cycle shop.
Yeah. Oh, that gives me the horn.
Or at the cycle shop, yeah. I'll tell you, when they set those wheels spinning, fucking hell.
Oh, you see, I see, I'm looking at that, I think that's beautiful. The way those spokes move around. And I'll get the horn looking at that. I think I'm going to wank myself to death.
What I was saying earlier, interesting you mentioned that. But when you get very old, you won't get the horn at all.
No,
and
well,
you'll be sitting in this room.
Oh, frankly, when
and
I...
you'll be looking at books and trying to look at the word and the, and you won't get the horn at all.
Frankly, when I don't get the horn, that's when I take the pills.
What you'll?
Because that gives me the horn.
What, taking pills?
Yeah.
Suicide gives you the horn, does it? Yeah, I get a bit excited by the idea of suicide.
Yeah.
Gives me the fucking horn of thought of lying there dying, you know, with all these pills and knowing that you're not quite strong enough to get to the phone and ring a doctor.
Oh, my knobbed and I've ache.
Yeah, I think of that and it gives me the fucking horn. I imagine Keith Moon had the horn when he was dying. That's probably why he took all those pills, like, wasn't it? So he'd get the horn through thinking of dying, but of course he overdid it and went and died. But being dead probably gives you the horn as well. I imagine when you're dead, you have the horn solidly, forever and ever and eternity.
Well,
I imagine God's got the horn, don't you? He's probably got a huge prick on him, hasn't he?
He's fucking wanked all over the world for a good 2,000 fucking years, mate.
Yeah, he's probably got the horn continuously.
Probably a terrible wanker.
Seraphim and cherubim continually to cry. And why did they continually cry? Because they all got the fucking horn up there.
Yeah, fucking knobs aching up there, mate. Continually crying with knob ache.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'd like to meet Ezekiel and have a few words with him.
Yeah, he's got
a fucking load of crap he wrote.
He's got a lot to answer for.
Leviticus, what a cunt.
Cunt. Herodotus, get fucked.
Yeah. Herodotus?
Leviathan, shove it.
Leviathan, was he a gospeler?
I don't know.
No, he's just some cunt.
Mate, just give me the horn. That's care about is the horn, mate. Oh. I live by the horn.
The book of fucking
I shall live... And die for the horn. That's all I'm interested in, is the horn.
I wrote to the Council of Churches, and I said, this fucking Bible, especially Paul.
Yeah.
I said, this fucking Bible really gives me the horn. And I wrote, you know, civilly to them at the World Council of Churches. I wrote, dear cunts in charge of religion, you know, familiar, right. Friendly. Dear cunts in charge of religion, your fucking guidebook or whatever the fucking thing is, don't half give me the horn. I get fucking horny, especially on St. Paul. And I got no reply whatsoever from that cunts. No wonder church attendance is dropping off.
No wonder. Everything's dropping off.
You know, like it says in the Bible, that Jesus on the whole was, you know, fairly nice.
Yeah.
Do you think that's true?
No, I think he was probably a cunt.
Yeah, I thought that, because, you know, I've read the Bible, and he comes across so well.
Yeah,
well,
he comes over a bit too goody-goody, doesn't he? I mean, he must have had his faults.
I reckon...
He probably got the horn a lot.
Well, if he didn't get the horn, then he wasn't human, was he?
No, right.
And they say he was half human and half God. Yeah. Well, which half was human? I bet it was the bottom half.
Mm.
The God bit was on the top, and the human bit had the horn.
Right.
I bet the God bit stopped at his navel.
Mm.
And then he had the human horn bit underneath.
Yeah.
So he could be wandering around feeling all nice and saying, I'm God up here, you see. But down below, I suppose his hand would be below, wouldn't it?
Depends.
His arm would start off as God and then become man as it reached about the wrist.
Probably, yeah, the wrist.
So he could be wanking himself silly. All the time his brain was saying he's been good and holy, you know. What a load of fucking cobblers that is, isn't it? But there was one bit of the Bible I think was cut out.
Yeah.
It was just after the devil had been tempting him.
Oh, yeah.
And the bit that was cut out said, and Jesus suddenly... No, it said, and lo...
The devil had the...
No, it said, and lo, Jesus suddenly got the horn and wandered out of the Garden of Gethsemane and fucked himself stupid for 28 years. And that bit got left out because I think it was Matthew thought it would be a bad idea, bad for the image.
Yeah.
When, of course, in my book, it makes him more understandable.
Oh, yeah, it makes him more human. Oh, well, that's wrong, isn't it? Yeah.
No, it makes the bottom half human, that's normal.
Yeah.
And the top half God.
Yeah, yeah.
They say his right hand didn't know what his left hand was doing.
Yeah.
Well, I know what his left hand was doing, the same as his right hand.
Yeah.
Fucking encouraging the horn. Mate. But they cut bits out of the Bible. Like, it never says Jesus got athlete's foot.
No, it never
from wandering around the desert.
Does it mention it?
Does it say, and lo, Jesus was stricken with athlete's foot? Is that in? No, it's fucking out. It doesn't fit in, does it?
Did it ever say...
With a picture of this holy cunt wandering around telling people to be good.
Did it ever say, and lo, Jesus had a wee-wee?
No.
No. Nowhere.
Are we to assume that Jesus, throughout his brief life, never had a piss? And if he did have a piss, why wasn't it fucking reported? Did he have a crap? Why wasn't it down? Why didn't Paul say, and Jesus went into the temple, had a piss, had a crap, wiped his ass with the money changers? and put all the stuff in which would make you human instead of all this shit about saying take up thy bed and walk to some cunt who's probably perfectly happy begging.
Right. Well, he's probably been misreported. When he said take up thy bed and walk, he said, where's the fucking bog? I'm dying for a slash.
That's what he probably said,
not take up thy bed and fucking walk.
He'd have said it in Hebrew, which is difficult.
Who would have said that? Take up thy bed and walk? It's a giveaway. Where's the fucking bog? I'm dying, mate. That's what it was.
Love thy neighbour as thyself. Love thy neighbour, I don't know, fancy her too, and rush him round for a quick one. He's a human being.
Oh, well, you can't blame him, can you?
No, of course you can't.
He had an image, mate. He had to preserve it. Just think of it.
But he gives me the horn.
Yeah?
Jesus. Those pictures of him.
Oh, he doesn't give me the horn. I've forgotten about him, actually. Valerie and Jesus both. Maybe it's that beard she's got.
Has it ever struck you that Valerie might be Jesus? Have you seen this sudden intercollection?
Hey, wait a moment.
This connection. The Jesus doesn't give her the horn. Valerie doesn't give her the horn. They both have beards.
And Valerie's got a knob.
Jesus had a knob.
Fucking hell, you've got.
Does she pin herself up on a cross every now and then?
Well,
of course she does. I saw. I got a Polaroid of that.
Well, I thought it was just a thing she had.
No, she's you've obviously married Jesus.
Oh.
Who's come back in the form of Valerie?
Oh, that's blimey.
Well, you better.
That's given me the horn.
But
I've got the horn! No. Do you realise I've got the horn?
But you don't get the horn for Jesus or for Valerie. No, but the thought of Jesus being Valerie gives you the horn. Well, it's proof, isn't it?
Fucking
two
hell,
in one and one in two, flushing both down the loo. I think Valerie is Jesus. If so, you're in shtuck, mate.
Oh, fucking hell. Oh, I've got the horn. Oh, I've got the horn. Everybody.
He's got the horn.
He's got the horn.
He's got the horn.
He's got the horn.
He's got the horn. He's got the horn. He's got the horn.
Yeah, he's got it. He's got the horn, all right.
He's got the horn. He's got the horn.
Fucking stalk on him.
He's got the horn. He's got the horn. He's got the horn. He's got the
He's got the horn. I haven't got the horn.
Nor have I.